the levels of the ocean. When we know about the levels of the ocean, only then we can test ourselves that where are we standing. If you have no idea of the levels of the ocean, then whatever we are doing, we think I'm all right, there is no problem, I'm practicing my devotion very well. But when we know the different levels of devotion and what do you accomplish at what stage of devotion, then you can assess that where are we standing, how much have I done and how much I have to do. Only then we can know it. And without knowing that, how can we make any progress? That's why yesterday I discussed about it and I told you the different levels when we start devotion. Then if we are progressing in our devotion, first of all we have to have the practice of singing the glories of God all the time in your mind. Because in the beginning it is very difficult to sit for at least 1 hour to chant. After half an hour, 15 minutes or 40 minutes, we get bored. After that, it's hard for us to sit down over there and keep chanting. Because so far, we don't love God. We have no love for God. We cannot, if your son has lost, you lost your son, you are searching your son, you don't find him for a couple of hours only, then you cry like anything. And sometimes the mothers get unconscious. But we are not seeing our Lord. We are not seeing God since eternity and we have no feeling. It means we do not love God even that much as we love our son, daughter and other family members. So first of all we have to make this practice that at least we can chant the names of God, and then we have to understand only chanting is not sufficient, we have to remember God. Only chanting the names is a physical drill, the drill of our tongue. But when we are remembering God also, then the chanting, the names of God is fruitful. It is worth doing that now. So we have to sing the glories and then we have to remember God. And I explained yesterday, remembering God means remember the divine form of God. Whenever we remember anybody in the world as well, then sometimes we forget the name. But we remember the face of that person. Who are you talking about? I call him who? Ramesh? No, no, no. Suresh? No, no, no. Mahesh? Oh, yes. Yeah, I am calling Mahesh. So you have the picture, you have the face of Mahesh in your mind, but you are busy and you cannot remember the name of your son Mahesh, but you know who you are calling, who you are talking about. In the same way, when we remember God, then we should have the face of God in our imagination, in our mind. We are simply pronouncing the names of God without having an image of God in our mind. It means the mind is going somewhere else. Because mind can never be inert. It has to do something. It has to remember something. So there are only two areas, the area of God and the area of Maya. So if our mind is not attached to the area of God, then obviously our mind is roaming around in the area of Maya. That's why it is very important to think about God. Remember what means to think about His form. When you are thinking about His form, you are focusing on the form of God only, then your mind will never go anywhere else. And if this kind of remembrance of God is called Roop Dhyan. Roop Dhyan. Roop means form, Dhyan means meditation. So meditation upon the divine form of God is called Roop Dhyan. It is very essential. Without Roop Dhyan, you do anything. Either you are worshipping God, doing aarti, or doing you are reading any book, Gita, Bhagavat, Ramayana, anything, but you are not doing Roop Dhyan, then you will get zero marks. As I explained before, because if you are not remembering God, then you are remembering someone or something else in the material world. So, number one, we have to have the practice of sitting to do kirtan, bhajan, worship, etc. for a longer time, and then not only that, we have to remember God. This is more important. Now, when you sit down for your chanting, for singing bhajan, etc., and you feel like doing Roop Dhyan also, you are thinking about the divine form of God as well. Now you can do it easily. Then we have to pay attention on the third stage of devotion. That is, we have to shed tears also. When we sing bhajans, when we remember God, at that time we will feel like shedding tears. Naturally, the tears come out of our eyes. It means you are going on the higher stage of devotion. And then we have to wait for Him all the time, being very, very desperate to see Him. Then we will be oblivious of our physical presence also. So these are the things which we have to practice in our sadhana bhakti. As I said before, but first of all, we have to start our devotion with sadhana bhakti. When our mind does not get attached to God, but we are trying to think about God. We are trying hard. We try to think about God, and we think about His attributes, His form, etc. And after 5 minutes, your mind goes somewhere else. And you, after some time, you notice, oh, I second year to think about God's form, but I'm thinking about something else. Then again you bring your mind over there, and again you try to think about God. So if you have to do some efforts, when we are able to think about the form of God after lots of efforts, making efforts is sadhana. When we are trying to remember Him, we are making efforts to remember Him, it's called sadhana bhakti. And when you are set at this, and now you can easily remember God, you can visualize the divine form of God, you can imagine the divine form of God easily. Now it has become easy, no problem, no lots of efforts. Then you reach bhav bhakti. In bhav bhakti, now you don't have to make efforts to do Roop Dhyan, to think about God. Rather, all the time you are thinking about God, and even one moment when you cannot think about God, you fail to think about God, seems to be an error and makes you restless. Oh, I wasted 1 minute without remembrance of God. This kind of condition is accomplished after bhav bhakti. And gradually this bhav bhakti also increases, and then by the grace of Guru and God, the divine power enters secretly in our heart and makes the heart divine. And then, because God is divine, only then we can see.